In Unity, it's possible to add physics forces to 2D objects within an area using effectors. The Area Effector 2D allows us to add physics forces to 2D objects which trigger or collide with it. Some example uses for this might be to create an area of a scene in which a fan blows objects in a certain direction, or to create a speed boost area in a top-down driving game. In our example scene, we have a hat which spawns coins. The coin prefab contains a sprite renderer, circle collider, and rigid body 2D with default values. The coins fall into our first area effector 2D, which is attached to our game object arrows right. When they enter the collider, they're propelled to the right, where they're caught and lifted by our second area effector 2D, which is attached to arrows up. For an area effector to function, it must be attached to a game object which also has a 2D collider. On the box collider 2D attached to arrows right, the used by effector field is set to true. If this field is not checked, you'll see a warning on your area effector component that the effector will not function until there's at least one enabled 2D collider with used by effector checked on this game object. Additionally, the box collider 2D should have its isTrigger field checked and set to true. This will allow the objects to enter the trigger volume in which they will be affected by the forces set in the area effector settings. Area effectors are designed to be used with triggers. It's possible to use an area effector with non-trigger colliders, but the forces will only be applied when the target collider is in contact with the source. To control what forces are applied when an object enters the trigger volume, the Area Effector 2D has the following settings. The Collider Mask allows users to include or exclude layers from being affected by this effector's forces. For more on layers, please see the information linked below. Here, the effector is affecting everything. The force direction is the angle at which the force will be applied in degrees ranging from 0 to 359.99. If we input a number greater than 359.99, it will clamp to 359.99. If we use a negative value, the force direction will be applied in the opposite direction. The force direction is calculated in world space, incrementing in a counterclockwise direction. If force direction is set to 0, the object will be pushed directly to the right. If set to 90, it will be pushed upwards. If set to 180, it will be pushed to the left. And if set to 270, it will be pushed down. Note that the force direction is relative to world space and not to the object's local rotation. Rotating the object will not rotate the direction which the force is applied in. The force magnitude is the magnitude of the force to be applied to each object while it remains within the trigger volume. In this case, we've set our force magnitude to 22 to give our objects a relatively gentle push towards our second effector. The force variation here is set to 0. Force variation allows us to add or subtract a random amount ranging from 0 to the amount specified. By setting force variation to a positive number, we can add between 0 and that number to the force magnitude, and by setting it to a negative number, we can subtract between 0 and that number. In the case of our first area effector 2D, we've set the drag and angular drag to 0. Modifying the drag values allows us to add drag or angular drag to 2D rigid bodies that enter the effector's trigger volume. The drag coefficients specified in the area effector 2D are applied in addition to any already set in the target object's rigid body 2D settings. In our second effector, attached to arrows up, we're using drag to catch and slow down the incoming coins so that we can then move them directly upwards. If we temporarily reduce the drag value from 10 to 0, we can see that the velocity of the coins causes them to pass through the trigger volume and out of it to the right. to demonstrate the angular drag and force target parameters of our Area Effector 2D, we've modified our scene slightly. We've added our Two Planks game object, which has a rigid body 2D attached, with two child objects, which hold a sprite renderer and Box Collider 2D. We've also duplicated our Arrows Right object to make Arrows Right 2. When we play our scene, you can see that the Two Planks object falls into the two Arrows Right effectors, is moved to the right, and then is moved upwards by arrows up. Currently, the angular drag is set to 0, and the force target is rigid body. Because the force target is rigid body, the force is applied to the center of mass of the rigid body and therefore does not cause rotation. If we highlight our three area effector objects and switch the force target to collider, and then play our scene again, we can see that setting the force target to collider causes the object to rotate. Angular drag allows us to slow an object's rotation as we increase the drag value. If we then switch the angular drag value for all three Area Effector 2Ds to 10, we can see that by increasing angular drag, the rotation still occurs, but is minimized. For more on area effectors, please see the information linked below.